day 39, and guess what? Cardiganless, because it's hot in California today. And you know, when the heat finally comes, you know, you turn on your air conditioner and it's just running behind. It just doesn't do the job. So I can't even pretend to have a cardigan on today. I can't put my sweater on. It's not happening. So here you go. It's just me. Hi, everybody. Day 39. How are you? Oh, I didn't even put my ears on. Look at that. I am just grooving today.
Here we go. I got it right here.
So,
it's going to be one of those days.
It is Thursday, day 39. And these are my in-ears that I discovered so I wouldn't have to wear headphones, but I can hear. No, I'm good. Thank you, love. Thank you. We're all here. Are you there? Are you there? You are everywhere. You are all across America, that's for sure. We got you in got Pennsylvania, sending love out to New Jersey. Did you see the Jersey for Jersey last night? Did you see Bruce sing Jersey Girl? Tomorrow's Bruce Springsteen Day, just for New Jersey. Yeah. And what else? Day 39. I learned so many things. Here, I'm not gonna do that, I'm fine. You can listen to me in the echoes is fine. It's not echo, it's just reverb. It's just reverb. But I went shopping today, and I found that it's very challenging it's challenging enough to open those fruit, you know, the little bags you get in the produce section, right? And then you try to find out which end is the opening end, and you open that end. And yeah, but now we all have our gloves on here, you know, because we're all gloves and we're all masked up and gloved up when we go shopping. And nearly impossible to open the bag up with the plastic gloves on. I stood there in the middle of Trader Joe's just. But I did it. Successful. Got it down. Did it. So it's the little things. It's the little accomplishments in life. Every day now. That's what we're about, aren't we? Day 39. I'm going to go do some requests today. Oh, yeah. Well, all the songs that I've done have actually been by request. And again, I love that you're requesting all of these. This is from the second album. This is this. I kind of had a strange relationship with the song because I know I look like this all confident rock star, right, and everything, but you know, I go through my own insecurities. I do, very much so. And I did back then, and I remember when I wrote this song, I felt like, oh, who am I to be singing all about this, you know? Who am I to... But now that I look back on it, I realize that we can all speak our truth. We can all say what's our feeling and our thought and our hopes and things. So I remember when I wrote this song, it was about thinking about how many things in my life had changed and gone, you know, like the miracle, the magic in childhood, right, you know? And then, you know, the falling in love for the first time and thinking, oh, this is it. And you get your heart broken, all that. You go through all that. And then finally realizing that I am part of a whole interconnected human race. Now that's exciting. So here's a song from Brave and Crazy. It's called My Back Door. When I was a child, I dreamed like a child of wonder. With my back in the grass, my eyes to the sky to see. I believed in the stars. I knew they cast a spell that I was under. With my fingers in the dirt, I was part of the earth. Every living thing was part of me. But it's gone. It's gone. It's gone. Gone, gone. I can't feel it. I can't feel it. Must have found a way. Then I fell in love. Love gave me a shot of pure desire. There was nothing else like this. This unimagined bliss. This ecstasy, yeah. Deep inside the night, I believed I saw the light ignite a fire. And it burned into my heart. It burned deep into the dark. I thought it would burn eternally. But it's gone, it's gone, it's gone, gone, gone. I can't feel it, I can't feel it. Must have found a way out my back door. Must have run away out my back door. 'Cause it's gone. Do you sit in my car? Have you seen in the alleys and on the back of some guitar? Is it sleeping in the hallway? Does it cry all night alone? Is it selling someone money? Does it want to come home? Yeah. Then I saw the world curled up deep. Lying on my sidewalk, the mouths are white and pale, telling all the tales, reality. So I picked up a sign, and I found my place in line, and I shouted, no talk. The men all painted proud, all loud, they're trying hard to kill my dream. It's gone. It's not gone. No. No, no, I can feel it. I can feel it. Oh, I can feel it. Don't let it run away out my back door. I'll never let it run away out my back door. No, I'm not gonna let it ever run away. I'm gonna understand I'm part of this great, beautiful world. Everything that's happened day by day, hey. Oh, all the beautiful rich colors and all the beautiful rich people and all the beautiful, beautiful, gorgeous. Oh, I'll never let it run away out my back door. Oh, we do got some New Jersey hollers. We're ready tomorrow for Jersey.
No, Jersey love that song.
Oh, they love that song. What? All right. I believe it. Okay, so now. Oh, can you bring me the picture right there of Tammy? Tammy Wynette. Because that just would be funny if, yeah. I'm going to do a Tammy Wynette song, and I'm going to tell you about Tammy Wynette. Okay. Ooh, look at that. Yeah. See what it says right here? It says, to Melissa, thanks. I love you, Tammy. I know. Now, I met Tammy Wynette in like I think it was 1989. I was doing something in New York City, and I had mentioned that she was an influence of mine, because she was when I was growing up. Some of the first songs I ever sang were Tammy Wynette songs. I told you that, you know, when I was first singing in the country bands back in Kansas, one of the big crowd pleasers, one of the showstoppers was "Stand By Your Man." I'm not going to do that song. but she'd read about that, and somebody told her, and her people reached out to my people and said, "Hey, would you like to come by?" So after my show or something, I don't remember, I went to see her at the Bottom Line. And I went backstage, and I was just so delighted to meet her and talk to her, and we exchanged numbers, and we kept in touch. And then when she was in Los Angeles, we would have lunch. I remember we had lunch one time, and she was so kind. She was so smart. She was very up on music. I mean, I was a brand new artist, and she really enjoyed my music, and that made me very happy. She wanted to collaborate with me, and we started making plans about doing a show together. We were going to do the Johnny Cash show. We were going to go into a women's prison. She knew about a women's prison that was run by women, that the warden was a woman, and she wanted to go do a show in one of those in that prison. And we were contacting HBO, and it was happening. And in the meantime, I had a show just after that down in Nashville, and I saw her. And you know what else you have to get, honey? Sorry, could you? Yeah, you remember where it is? It's right by the. It's in the New Zealand desk. Yes, that's a long story. Okay, but this is the story of this. So I go to her house in Nashville, which is on the end of, I think it's called Franklin Road or something. It's a beautiful, there you go. It's a beautiful, it's where all the beautiful Nashville country artists, you know, live. And she bought Hank Williams Sr., you know, the guy, Hank Williams's house, his last house that he was in before he died. So they bought it from his wife at the time. And they were walking around going, okay, we are remodeling the house. And they took me around. They took me back to the master bathroom that they were getting ready to demolish. And it was very elaborate, you know, very lots of fancy, you know, things. That was kind of the style back in the 60s, 70s, right around there. And I looked at the sink, right, and the hot and cold, you know, faucet things, and they were these fancy, like, parrots. And I said, "Oh, my God, that's amazing." He goes, "Hey, you want it?" Pulled it off, gave it to me. Yes, I have, via Tammy Wynette, Hank Williams' master bathroom. What do you call these? What do you call the things that you turn the cotton cold spigot? No, not the spigots, the thing. The faucet handle. There's got to be a word for it. I'm sure someone will tell me. But look at that. It is truly, it's a very special thing of mine. And I keep it actually in the entryway. Can you believe that? Hank Williams and Tammy Wynette both, after they get out of the bathtub, used it. I'm just saying. Oh, thank you. But that's my Tammy Wynette story. And then not long after that, sweet Tammy passed away. She'd had a lot of health problems. She passed away, and she passed away before we could put the deal together to do a prison show. I would have loved that. I just would have loved that. And I think of her often. And after she passed away, they put a tribute album together. And they said, "Melissa, would you do a song?" Absolutely. So I did one of her, it's actually her first, I believe it's her first single. And it It's just such a sad song, and she used to just sing the sad. Her songs back in the 60s were just, oh, just tear your heart apart, and they were real, you know, like our D-I-V-O-R-C-E. Nobody was singing about divorce, and she was brave, man. She was, you got to see this country PBS special. Watch that. It's the Ken Burns documentary on country. It's amazing. You learn so much about her and George Jones and all that. So I did this song for the album, and I got some requests for it. So I said, yeah, I'll do Tammy, and I'll tell you my Tammy Wynette stories. Just follow the stairway to this lonely world of mine. You'll find me waiting there in apartment number 9. Not so very long ago, you walked away from me. And after all the plans we made, you decided to be free. Loneliness surrounds me without your arms around me, and the sun will never shine in apartment number 9. I keep waiting in this lonely room for you to come change your mind. Oh, you'll find me waiting here in apartment number 9. Loneliness surrounds me without your arms around me, and the sun will never shine in apartment number 9. Nor the sun in apartment number 9. Hey. Thank you. Oh, Tammy Wynette. We'll never forget Tammy. Okay. So glad you could come for this song, Bailey. It's, I'm kidding. All right, we're going to do a song from, This Is Me. Yeah. So much fun doing that. Now, oh, really? This is what happens when you put your ears on late. No, I'm fine. I just got to do this because that's why I'm supposed to put my ears on first, because I had my guitar on, and then you get all, what's going on? I know, Paul, it just wouldn't happen if I had my crew. But I don't.
A fan kind of called it.
That was good. They knew it when it was going on. Oh, my God. No, Melissa, it's going to. I know. See? Okay, back to the ears again. Boy, do I miss my crew. And that's a good time to bring up the GoFundMe for my crew who has not been working. And I so appreciate you guys put together a GoFundMe for them. You've been donating a little bit each time, and it's really going to make a difference to them and their families. They, you know, us in the entertainment industry, we need people to work. We need crowds to to do our work. And there are skilled people who are out of work right now. So the GoFundMe, I'm sure Karen Maroney is putting it up on the feed right now. It's the GoFundMe. It's Fans for Melissa Etheridge and crew. And just please, it's blessed by me. The money is going to my 10 members of my crew. And they're very beloved to me. They've been working with me for a long time, and they would not ever have let that happen. They would not have let me put my ears on after my guitar, because that doesn't make sense. Nope. Uh-huh. But they've still been helping me, even though they haven't been paid. They helped me on the phone. They helped me put all this together, and just beautiful, wonderful people. They're just like family to me. All right. Now, back to This Is Me. One of my favorite songs from This Is Me. All right, it's a crazy song. And no matter how old you get, you should never stop loving, you know, never stop all the different ways of loving. I'm just saying, I could go into detail about this, but I don't need to. Okay. All right, what's the beat? That's the beat. Some singing along. I don't care about your neighbors. I don't care about your family in the other room and you're cooking dinner and you're dancing around. I know you are. I know you are. You gotta sing loud. Yeah, you do. glad I don't have my cardigan on. Yeah, a lot of people requested that. A lot of people said that that was their driving home music. And that makes me happy. I'm going to have to do that live again. We're going to have to. So many of these songs that because of you, because of all this, I have come to love again and bring back into my world. And that makes me very happy. So I think I'll bring that song back. I think so. I haven't played it in 5 or 6 years. Now I'm all thirsty. So, are we ready for Springsteen night tomorrow night?
Yes!
Oh yeah, we were gonna answer questions today. Did we have any? I forgot about that.
New Zealand desk.
So now you wanna know my New Zealand desk, okay. Huh. One of the first times I was in New Zealand, I'll take a picture of it eventually. There's a desk from an old school in New Zealand. It was an antique desk, and it had it has Maori. It's like a desk from like an English school, you know, where they're trying to teach the Maori kids how to be, you know, whatever they would teach them. And this desk has carvings all over it, amazing Maori carvings, and you know, all this that they would just carve into it. It's amazing, and that's my New Zealand desk that is. Right as I walk into the, if you were to walk into my house, you would see it right there. Yes, yeah, so, all right, we are, there's so many things happening. What? Do I have a favorite photo shoot? Oh, of all the photo shoots I've done, and I have done many photo shoots. One of my favorite photo shoots of mine was I was actually just thinking about that the other day, from Fearless Love. We went into a stage to a theater and like lit it like a show, and he took pictures, and the I don't remember who the photographer was, oops, James somebody, and he took just great pictures, you know, it's the cover in my fringe jacket, and I just really like a lot of it, and there's a photo that we used on some posters. And my hair was, you know, it's the hair thing, you know, the hair flip, and it's this really great picture like that. And we use that for the European tour, so I really like those photos. Yes, what else, love? My necklaces. What's up with the necklaces? All right, I usually wear. What's that over here? I usually wear lots of different types of necklaces when I'm on stage, and so I just kind of, right as everything started 39 days ago, I just. These were the necklaces I had, and they were out, and I didn't feel like, one of the reasons I wore the cardigan is I didn't know how to dress for this, because I wasn't like on stage and glittery and leathery and stuff. I was in my office, so I've just been putting these on. These are, I wear these kind of a lot, obviously. There's a peace sign, of course, for peace. This is just a silver chain, and this one is a grenade of love. That's what it says. It says grenade, love grenades. Yeah, and it's, you know, like the pin from a grenade, so, but it's a love grenade. And those are my necklaces. And I feel dressed up then when I put my black shirt on and put my necklaces on, I'm dressed up for you. And wash my hair and stuff like that. All right, so moving into the weekend. Come on, it's Thursday night. Some of you in Europe, it's already, hey, Australia and New Zealand's already Friday. Yep, it's already there. So, here you go. I get, hold on. There. I get lots of requests, and I'm trying to do them all. And this one, that's gonna blow away. Nope, it's okay. I got it right there. Yep. There. This one's for a special fella, because it's his birthday. This song is, okay, it's not even a bonus song on one of the, What are you laughing about? Oh, you're coughing. Oh, I thought my daughter was laughing. But she's coughing, so she's leaving the room. So this song wasn't even a bonus song. A few years ago, I was thinking about making a box set for you guys before I went independent. I was with, you know, Island Records, and I thought, let me go in and dig up all these old things that didn't make it to the album, you know, songs that you probably would like, songs like this, which is a really good song. And I listen to it now and I go, oh, now why didn't I put that on the album? That's a good album. But I had a lot of songs for Breakdown. What? Oh, yeah, yeah. My wife is saying, has anyone ever heard it? Yes. Because a few years ago, when I realized that the box set wasn't going to happen because it would make Island a lot of money, but it wouldn't make me any money, and that kind of, So I decided to put it on my website. So actually the fan club. If you were a member of the fan club, Etheridge Nation, now you can join still. Lots of fun stuff like this you can get. I put them on so you could listen to them. And I would put one on every month or every week. I forgot what it was. But this was one of them, and it was a fan favorite. The fans that heard the song really liked this. So, oh, I meant to get the book. Oh, no, it's, you think it? No, you're going to have to get a ladder to get it. They're so helpful. They like, I can do it, it's in our library. You know where the children's books are up top? No, you remember, you know what book I'm talking about as she leaves? The Monarch X. The Adventures of the Monarch X. they're gonna be gone a while. It's way up there. They're never gonna. They might find it. I don't know. But they're looking for it. My crew went looking for it. So, just me and you now. So anyway, when I was a child, one of my favorite books was The Adventures of the Monarch X, and it was a book in the 60s about when the first time that they actually traced the butterfly's journey. They had no idea, and it started in like Canada, and they traced it, and it flew all the way down. Okay, so if you're facing the, excuse me, everyone, I'm talking to my. If you're facing, it's like the old books up. If you're facing the librarian here, it's to the right. You know, it's not in the first thing, not in the second thing, but I think it's like the third thing, the top two, and it's where my old children's books are up there. Okay. By the time they find it, the song will be over, or maybe not. But this book that I had, which is in my library, and I meant to bring it down. Oh, I forgot. It's a little busy today. Busy running around my house doing things. Shopping. You know, today was grocery store day. I told you about that. Anyway, the Monarch X. It started in Canada, and then it went all the way down to South America. And they were just mind blown. The scientists were that these little butterflies made it. The no way you found it, Bailey. Awesomeness. And here it is. The Travels of the Monarch X. Yes. Look at that. There's the book. Da, 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 da. You guys rock. You guys rock. Yeah. And there, and I would read it, and it talked about, oh, yes. Shall I read? No, I'm not going to read the whole book. But it starts in, the milkweed plant grew in a meadow in Canada just north of Lake Ontario. And it goes from a egg all the way, you know, to the caterpillar. Ooh, 2 weeks passed. So it goes through this whole chrysalis journey. And then the butterfly appears. And then it takes off. And then it goes. And they put, it talks about how they put, they put a little note on it right there that says, if you find this butterfly, send it to the museum in Toronto. They put a little tiny thing on it, and then it took off and did its thing, and it came back. It had gone through everywhere, all the way, and it ended up Oh, it went, it's got alligators, all kinds of things. Here, they went through Georgia. They went all the way down, and they ended up in, down in Mexico. Look, it went all the way to Mexico. Oh, and it really changed their ideas about nature and certainly about butterflies. And it was, that's story time, folks. So I, when I was writing songs for Breakdown, I thought about this Monarch X. I thought about how you can grow up in one place and how you can be a caterpillar, how you can then spread your wings, become a butterfly, and travel and change who you are and change the world, you know? And so I wrote a song about it. Called it the Monarch X. They saw red, I saw blue. They wanted me to lie, I bled the truth. Vision spilling as I slept. I watched, they fell, I never wept. All across the universe, on a butterfly's wings, I shed my curse, I shed my curse. No anger, no tears, no fears, no sex. I'm learning to fly like a monarch X. You try, you're aching, then you die. But I'm learning to fly like a monarch. Hey. A prison town, a prison mind. It's best to lie down, surrender to survive. I knew my place, I knew my name. Swallow memory, shouldered all the shame. All across the universe, on a butterfly's wings, I shed my curse, I shed my curse. No anger, no tears, no fears, no sex. I'm learning to fly like a monarch X. You feel, you try, you ache and then you die. Don't forget to call, don't forget to write. I defied my fate, set myself free. Found the courage just to see. All across the universe, on a butterfly's wings, I shed my curse, I shed my curse. No fears, no sex. I'm learning to fly like a monarch. You feel, you try, you wake and then you die. I'm learning to fly like a monarch. Oh, oh. You feel, you try, you ache and then you die. But I'm learning to fly like a monarch. Time. All right, my friends, thank you so much. That's concert 39, to be remembered. Tomorrow's concert 40, Springsteen Day. I've been practicing. It was great seeing him last night. Oh, that was awesome. And just sending love out to New Jersey. Absolutely sending love to New York, sending love all over the world, because we're all going through this. And we're all staying at home. And that's why I hope I can bring you some, just a little bit of joy every day. That brings me joy. Be strong, my friends. Speak true. Spread the peace. Choose only love. It's a choice. I'm thinking about you. Can't wait to see you tomorrow. I'll be here every single day till this is over. I love you.